Penguins, you're watching the KPHE Penguin News Now with their hosts Olive
and George. Today is Tuesday, October 8th, 2019. This is our 26th day of school. There are now 154 days left to go. Tuesday lunchroom helpers, please report to Mr. West as soon as you're finished eating.
Our weather today will be wet all day long, but it's supposed to clear up and be sunny the next couple of days.
We only have 1 week left to encourage our parents to join the PTA so we can earn that popsicle party for the entire school. Please remind your parents to go on a line and join the Prune Hill PTA.
Remember that we are collecting new socks for Socktober. Please bring new socks and turn them into the big green by the office. Look for the big orange sign.
Rooms 21 and 22 are on a field trip to the PUD, and kindergarteners are at Busy Farms today.
Tomorrow, there'll be a safety assembly in the gym at 8:15, and second graders will be going on a field trip to downtown campus.
Penguins, you have an opportunity to have your artwork on this cover for the yearbook. You have until Thursday, October 31st, to submit your original artwork on an 8.5 by 11 inch sheet of paper. Winners will earn a free yearbook.
Penguin Spirit Wear is now available. Flyers went out last week, and you have until October 19th to order online at papermakerpride.com.
This Friday, there will be no school because teachers will be taking classes all day.
Our Penguin Pride winners for the week are Addie in room 2 gets to have Miss Swan's chair on Wednesday. Durf Beebe with Mr. Durfee was won by Charlie in room 7, Macy in room 6, Trevor in room 20, and Jameson in room 21. Mr. Durfee will come and get you when it's time to play.
Emmett in room 6 gets to have a special teacher time with Mrs. Rush. She will contact you to make plans.
The classroom that won the classroom popcorn party is room 18, thanks to our winner, Madden.
The Penguin Trophy will get to sit on Brandon's desk in room 19, and the recess teacher for the week is Miley in room 19.
Nevaeh in room 21 gets to go on a walk with Miss Bargy and Tulip this week. Lincoln in room 6 gets to play games with Miss Kim in the library.
And finally, Elise in room 20 won time with Miss Lineski in the library. Congratulations, Penguin Pride winners.
We'd like to wish Modesty in room 13, Brady in room 40, Sonica in room 41, and Bailey in room 41 a very
happy birthday!
It's time for Everybody Has a Story segment. Today is Teacher Tuesday, so we are going to meet another one of our amazing teachers.
Good morning, boys and girls. It's Mrs. Lineski. I'm going to come to you with stories about my life instead of stories about the library. And when I was a little girl, I was the oldest of four girls. And we moved a couple times in elementary school. And I just wanted to tell you what that was like. So I started at Kingston Elementary in Toledo, Ohio. That was kindergarten. And I moved to first grade in Whitehall outside of Columbus, Ohio. And we moved around a little bit. And I can't really remember what it was like to be a new kid in Whitehall, but I always remember that I had a really nice teacher, Mrs. McDonald. When I went to second grade in Bexley, which was a great place to go to school, I went to Montrose Elementary, and I stayed there from second to fifth grade. And after that, I'm just kind of explaining a little bit of my moving around. In fifth grade, I moved out to the country in Lancaster, Ohio. So And after that, I moved to Perrysburg, Ohio, which was the suburbs. So when I was growing up, I had a unique experience of what it's like to live in the city as a kid, what it's like to live in the country, and what it's like to live in the suburbs. And when I lived in the city, I really liked it because I could ride my bicycle to the library or up to the school to see which class I was in for the next year, or play on the playground, or explore this college campus that was right next to my house. So that was my experience of being in the city. When I lived in the country, I joined 4-H. I learned how to oil paint. I learned how to sew. I didn't really raise animals because we didn't live in a on a farm. But I did used to walk my friend's heifer, you know, for fun. Like we would go for a walk with the heifer, like you would a dog. It was kind of funny. A heifer is a cow. And then I moved to the suburbs, and all the kids like hung out in the malls, and I was in seventh grade, so that's kind of like mall age maybe. Anyway, that was a real different experience to me, and I actually prefer the city or the country. Anyway, all of this is leading to one message I wanted to give you, which is that I really want to compliment the people who have reached out to the new kids in our school. I remember what it's like to be a new kid. It's, you know, awkward, like you might have guessed. If you've lived here your whole life, you're pretty comfortable. And of course, a new kid is uncomfortable, at least at first. And every time that you include them in a game that you're playing out on recess, or maybe if you have to choose partners, you choose them in class. Anytime that you do things like that, it's really going to help them feel a lot more comfortable really fast. And I see kids doing those little nice things all the time. And I just want to say, as a kid who moved around a lot, it's really appreciated. Thank you.
Thanks so much for sharing a little bit about yourself.
It's time for Specialist Spotlight with Miss Ray and Miss Bender, our music teachers.
Good morning, Prune Hill Penguins. Mrs. Ray, Mrs. Bender. Hope you're having a great start to your day. Just want to encourage those people in a recorder choir to be coming on Wednesdays right after school. We're fifth grade right now. We'll be adding fourth grade in the month of October. It's very exciting. Mrs. Bender.
And we have vocal choir today after school from 2:30 to 3:30, so I'm really looking forward to it. Thank you.
Have a good week.
Bye.
Penguins, on this day in history in 1957, the Brooklyn Dodgers announced that they were moving from Brooklyn, New York to Los Angeles, California.
Let's all show our penguin pride by being safe, respectful, and responsible. This is Olive.
And George saying goodbye from the Penguin News Studio.
Have a terrific Tuesday!